was out, they pulled me back in.
KP! KP in the house! You already know how to bounce!
It's Disney Detonation coming at you from the Transformative Content Fair Studios in New Jersey, and I'm your host, and today is a KP episode. I know I said I wasn't going to do one this week, but he came out with such a spectacular video, a vlog this week that I just couldn't ignore it. I mean, just click it. Like, he is like, every week he's got, it's like hitting the jackpot with this guy, with content. This vlog, or this episode's called KP and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day. I mean, this vlog of his might be the most narcissistic, self-absorbed vlog that he's put out so far, and that's saying something. So let's get into it. The first clip is called Open the Wine.
Today is not my day, and it kind of stinks because today is my birthday, and it's supposed to be a day of celebration. It's my YouTube birthday. I've been on YouTube for 12 years now, and I'm very stressed. I have been feeling this pressure more recently, and I was gonna go to the Disney parks today. I still might, but it's like I've been finding a reason not to go to the Disney parks recently. I might be feeling burnt out. You know, I have a YouTube channel to run. I go every single day. I have for the past, but I really haven't had a break, and I might need two breaks. I'm feeling burnt out a little bit more.
He might need two breaks from videotaping himself at amusement parks.
I shouldn't be finding an excuse not to film, you know? I should be finding excuses to go film.
I mean, like, I've listened to this clip 100 times already, and I can't stop laughing at it. Listen to this. All right, let me play. It's just...
I shouldn't be finding an excuse not to film, you know? I should be finding excuses to go film.
He shouldn't be finding excuses not to film. He should be finding excuses to film. I mean, like, where did this guy learn English? Didn't he go to a decent college? It's amazing. Unbelievable. So the next clip is called I'm Real.
I feel like as the years go on of me being, this is like my fourth year on YouTube, I've been on YouTube for 12 years now. I don't want to hide these feelings anymore. I just want to be real on how I'm feeling.
I'm real, okay?
I mean, it begets the question. So he's telling us that he hasn't been honest with his feelings thus far. Now he has. I mean, like, so you've been lying this whole time? Like, it just...
I almost didn't vlog.
Wow.
Today. I feel like I shouldn't be feeling this way, you know?
And that's the triple sniff. Every time that he does that sniff thing, I'm doing it, clipping it three times in a row. Like, it's just this weird way of either he's like, it's like an exclamation point, or he feels like he just made this, you know, this hard-hitting, this salient point. So the next clip is, you don't understand. And this is where we get into the meat of this guy's narcissism and cluelessness about the rest, you know, the rest of the world. So let's get into it. It's called You Don't Understand.
Like, it's just, it's hard to explain to those of you who aren't creators. I feel like a lot of daily vloggers, or just a lot of creators in general, can relate to this. Or just like, think about when you work every day.
It's hard for us to understand. Think about if you work every day. Most of us work every day, or at least 5 days a week.
Or you go do something every day. You eventually get tired. I'm trying to restructure my YouTube brand off camera that you guys don't really know yet.
JoJo and I were starting a brand, and it's gonna be called Dreamers.
There's just a lot overwhelming me, and right now it just feels like it's so much. And I've never really experienced this in my 4 years of being a YouTuber.
I've been on YouTube for 12 years now.
I mean, he's the one who's he's putting this stuff out. He's literally contradicting himself from moment to moment. All right, so the next clip is called It Takes a Lot to Push Out a Turd.
And I wouldn't be here without posting daily. So that's why, like, when you're a daily creator, it's just like, it's so hard mentally to stop. It is so hard. It's addicting. It really is. Maybe I'm trying to convince myself that I do need a break sooner than I thought, but I don't want to because I want to push myself extra, and I feel like that's what I've done for these past.
Can you imagine? He's talking about pushing himself to go to an amusement park and record
four
himself.
4 years or 3 years. I've pushed myself so much to my limits.
To his limits. I mean, like, this guy's never had adversity in his life, apparently. I mean, I don't know about the rest of you, but I went to college. I paid my own way. Like, there were a couple years where I worked a landscaping service in the summer and during the day and worked at the bar at night to try to, you know, get money for tuition and for room and board. I mean, like, and then I played sports in college and then, you know, and train.
But you need to be successful in anything you do. If anything you've learned from me being a full-time creator for 3 years now, it's that it is hard work. Anything you do, you have to put your all in today. And I feel like if I went to Disney, I wouldn't put my all in today. And normally I wouldn't make this video. I would have pushed myself to do that in the past. But now I feel like in 2024, I want to take care of me and do what I love to do, you know? I feel like I'm realizing that life isn't over.
Unbelievable. Okay, so the next clip is called The Turd Is in the Bowl. So, like, let's just play it.
Actually, what I'm saying is I need more.
So here's him pushing himself, you know, playing putt-putt golf in his house. And prior to this, he was walking around on an amusement park, balancing on a retaining wall.
Life to be less
I mean,
of
how can anyone take this guy seriously at this point?
And more of just kind of enjoying the moment, because as much as I enjoy it, jeez, I suck at this. Enjoy vlogging. I also just need to enjoy things off camera. And that's going to be a huge adjustment for me this year somehow.
So the only time he enjoys everything is, it sounds like a baby with a tape recorder. I mean, like, okay, so the next clip is called Content First Bullshit.
Some things up my sleeve for this year that I'm going to be trying to change that I have thought about.
This is him balancing on the retaining wall. This is...
Yeah.
I've
never experienced this as a creator, especially on my YouTube birthday, you know? Out of old days, I'm just like...
Amazing.
Maybe let's not do that and do something for Kyle.
You dick!
I made the choice to put my life before the content that I film. I feel like my content has taken a back burner this year because of my relationship. You know? Because I feel like for these past... Now into year four. I've been on YouTube for 12 years now. I've really always put the channel first.
I mean, this almost seems like a made-up character at this point. Like, it's insane. So the next clip is called Nostra Dumbass. So because I went back last week and looked at a bunch of his content from a couple of years ago, he's like... He was taking questions from his quote-unquote audience or, you know, subscribers and gave a completely different answer to a question. Like, I'm going to play it. You'll see firsthand.
Luck, talent, hard work. Which of these are more important when becoming a creator? Well, you can have three of those actually happen. You can be lucky and your first video goes viral. Luck might not have anything to do with it, really. It's more about the talent and the hard work.
Technically, sometimes you just have to get lucky on YouTube. It's all about luck, in a way. I mean, you can have the best videos, no one's gonna watch it. So I just think it's all about luck, in my opinion.
More of the hard work and the talent combined together, because you can have the talent, but then you don't have the hard work. You can have the hard work, but you're not cut out for it. But the more you do something, the better you get at it. So the harder you work, the more talented you get at what you're doing. So hard work and talent, I feel like, are combined. Luck, you could get lucky, but then you don't have the hard work to build upon that, or the talent. So, yeah.
I mean, and he talks as though, like, he's like this aficionado, like this knowledgeable person. If you don't have the talent to do something, no matter how hard you work, you're not going to gain talent. It's madness, absolute madness. Okay, so the next clip is called 30 subscriptions and a $2,000 camera equals nothing. Now, this is what I was talking about in just prior video, prior vlog that I did. He's claiming that he started out of nothing for the past 4 years. He started with 30,000 subscribers and it had the ability to purchase a $2,000 camera. Now, that somebody who started from nothing is like Adam the Woo, where he quit his $10 an hour job at a feed place and lived in the back of his car. That's starting from nothing. Okay, you didn't start from nothing. And the fact that you keep saying that is just, it's insanity. Absolute insanity. So here we go. It's called 30,000 subscribers and a $2,000 camera equals nothing.
It's like, I'm very thankful for everything that I've been able to accomplish. Like, I mean, when I first started my channel, I was back in high school. And when I first literally went full time on YouTube, I had nothing. I literally had nothing again.
The reason why I'm kind of explaining all this is because, again, I only had 30,000 subscribers back in the day when I jumped into YouTube full time.
Very soon, I'm going to be getting a new camera. Like a lot of you guys have been asking that for the past year. I'm going to be updating. It's about like $2,000.
Went full time on YouTube. I had nothing. I literally had nothing. Like, I owe it all to you guys. So a lot of the stuff when I'm talking about things, I just feel like I owe it to you guys because, you know, I wouldn't be here without you guys. Like,
okay, and this next clip is called KP Map. Now here he talks about like revenue for his quote unquote business or YouTube channel, and he's like, I think I made 15% last year, or was it 20%? I mean, like, if you're a business owner and you there's a big difference in a 5%. Plus or minus change in your profits. So you would know that immediately. Like the fact that he's like, and then goes on to say how much he's sharing with you. Okay, I mean, this is just spectacular. Here we go, KP Math.
I just look into analytics way too much, you know? And I feel like if I look at YouTube as a business, you know, my revenue went up, I want to say 20%. 15%.
What's 21 times 4? 64? Good math, Mom. I was doing girl math.
I don't know. I just like to be open about that stuff. Some people might not agree, but me as a daily creator, I feel like I just owe it to you guys to be pretty transparent. And I don't know. I just like when YouTubers share that stuff. So,
you're not transparent at all about anything ever. I mean, like, there's clips of you with, I have another clip that I'm not playing now about, you talk about your housing situation again. It's completely unclear. So to sit there and say that you made a 15%, possibly 20% profit last year is not being forthwith or clear to your subscribers. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, and he's right. You listen to your analytics. YouTube will tell you what you should and shouldn't be doing as far as your content. YouTube is telling me that I shouldn't be doing content over 10 minutes. They're telling me the age range of my subscribers. They're telling me 80% of the people that watch my videos aren't subscribed. And not once will you ever hear me say, please like and subscribe. Please comment. If you want to subscribe, subscribe. If you don't, don't. If you want to comment, comment. If you don't. You know, like these types of things, either they happen or they don't. Now, this last clip is called Missing Genitals. And this is the last clip for today. And I just did this vlog on this most recent vlog where he's, you know, having this terrible, horrible, no good, very, very bad day. But I have so much content that I haven't even put in here. So, but I will. I think what I'm going to do, and I'm not promising or not, saying, you know, that I'm going to do it. But my thought is I might start putting a bunch of different vlogs together, 10 minutes, 14 minutes, 5 minutes, and stagger them throughout the week. I don't know if I'm going to do it. I'm thinking about it. So here we go. The last thing is called Missing Genitals.
Decisions, right? I don't know how to explain it other than like this anxiety that I have right now. And I'm kind of like not pushing it off. I'm really good at pushing off feelings when it comes to YouTube and stuff. Having a daily show is tough. It is tough. It is tough. And now I'm kind of like just seeing it in year four on how tough it can be and how much it does take a toll. It really does. in ways that I really didn't see it, but now I'm seeing it.
That's ridiculous, Mo, and transmission.